Now we will start the sums of lesson number 6, subsidiary books. The first sum, that is question number 4 on page number 151. Now before we start the sum, let us revise little bit of theory portion, that which things are to be recorded in purchase book. Clear? See, first thing which you have to record in purchase book, that is credit transactions of only goods are to be recorded. Clear? This is your first important thing, that is credit transactions of only goods are to be recorded. Second important topic, that is cash transactions and asset transactions are not recorded. Fine? Cash transaction and assets transactions are not to be recorded. Third important thing, partly amount paid in cash is to be ignored and consider it as credit transaction. Fine. These three important things you have to remember when you are doing the sum. First is credit transactions of only goods are to be recorded. Cash transaction and asset transaction are not to be recorded. If partly amount is paid in cash, then ignore it and consider it as a cash transaction. Now the sum which is given to us, that is question number 4, prepare purchase book in the books of Sri Suresh. Now see, when you are preparing the book, this is the format. Fine. Question number 4, purchase book of Sri Suresh, date, name of supplier, inward invoice number, LF and amount. Clear? So this is in case of purchase book. Here what you will write down, you will write down name of supplier that we have seen in theory portion, and here you will write down inward invoice number. When you are preparing sales book, supplier will be changed by customer, inward invoice will be changed by outward invoice number. Clear? Now we will start the sum. See the first transaction. Purchase goods of rupees 10,000 from Deepak on 1 month credit. See, very clearly it is mentioned that this is purchased on credit. And from whom you are purchasing? So Deepak account. So first we will write down the date, that is 2015, October 1st. So see here we will write down 2015, October 1st. Clear? Now what was the party's name? Deepak. So here we will write down Deepak account. Fine. Inward invoice number is not mentioned, so put here dash. What is the amount they have given? 10,000 rupees. So here write down, that is 10,000. Clear? This first transaction is over. Then see the next transaction. Third, purchase goods of 20,000 rupees from Sardar Stores at 10% trade discount. Invoice number is 116. Fine. Here see, purchase from Sardar Store. The name of the shop is given. Clear? Now here the name of the shop is given, it means it is a credit transaction, and for that you have to also consider 10% trade discount. So don't forget that also. Inward invoice number is 116. So party's name is Sardar Store account. Here we will write down date is 3rd Sardar Store account. Inward invoice number was 116. Fine. And amount. So what was the amount? 20,000 and minus 10% trade discount. So when you do the calculation on calculator, what you will be getting? So 20,000, see here, 20,000 minus 10% trade discount, what you are getting? 18,000. So here we will write down, that is 18,000. Clear? Then next transaction is what? Purchase goods of rupees 18,000 from Pankaj on cash. See, as cash is mentioned, so here what you'll put the cross. No entry will be given for this transaction. Clear? Next transaction, placed order. See, no need to read further. You are just placing an order with Rajesh for supplying the goods of 20,000 at 10% discount. Here when you are placing an order, it is a non-economic transaction, so again this also won't be recorded. Next, purchase furniture. Again, no need to read further. So as you are purchasing an asset, so no entry is to be given. So 7th, 15th and 20th dated transactions, so no entry will be given for this transaction. Next, 21st date. Rajesh has sent goods as per the order and sent invoice number 350 after adding 1000 for railway freight. See here, when we are preparing, there is no column for the expense, as there is no column, separate column for railway freight. So you will not include railway freight in this sum. Clear? Where you'll record the railway freight amount? So you'll record the railway freight amount in the journal proper. Fine. It won't be recorded here. Now see, what is the party's name? Rajesh. So 21 we will put here. Rajesh account. Fine. And here after that, what they have mentioned, see, amount is, invoice number is 350. So here write down 350. Now see, in this transaction on dated 21st, there is no amount written. Okay, so amount is written here in the transaction number, that is for the date 15, that is Rajesh was supplying goods 20,000 at 10% trade discount. So again 20,000 and 10% trade discount, so again we'll get the same amount, that is 18,000. So here we will write down 18,000. Clear? Then next transaction, see, purchase goods of rupees 14,000 at 5% cash discount. See, nothing is mentioned, it means it is a cash transaction. Fine. Then purchase goods of 30,000 from Nilesh at 10% trade discount and half the amount is paid immediately by check. See, this half the amount which is paid immediately by check, we will ignore and we will consider a transaction till here only. Nilesh name is there, it means party's name, so it is a credit transaction. So here the date is 25th. Nilesh account. Fine. Okay, and then what is the amount? 30,000 minus 10% trade discount. So see, you will get 27,000. 30,000 minus 10%, so how much you are getting? 27,000. So here we will write down 27,000. And in this sum there was invoice number is not mentioned, so here what you will do, here you will put dash. Fine. Now see further. What is mentioned? See, purchase goods of rupees 15,000 from Chirag at 10% trade discount and 5% cash discount, amount paid immediately. See here, the amount, full amount is paid immediately. So again, this is a cash transaction, it won't be recorded. Next transaction, see what they have given. Purchase goods of 40,000 from Nitin, invoice number is 151. So this goods you are purchasing from Nitin, party's name is there, it means it is a credit transaction. Okay, invoice number is 151. So here we will write down invoice number 151, date is 30, party's name is Nitin account, and there is no trade discount, nothing is mentioned, so directly 40,000 we will write down here. Fine. Now what you'll do, you'll add it up all. So when you add all this, what you get? You get, that is total credit purchases. Fine. So here do the addition and write down the amount. What is the amount? We will see 10,000 plus 18,000 plus 18,000 plus 27,000 plus 40,000. What you are getting? 1,13,000. So here we will write down 1,13,000. Okay, so see, this is the advantage from journal entry. At a time, can you find out that how many how much credit sales is taking place in the month of October? But with the help of a subsidiary book, you can find out from this subsidiary book, purchase book, you can find out, and you can say that total credit purchases in the month of October is how much. So that is 1,13,000. Clear? So this is the advantage of subsidiary book, and this was the sum. Now we will see the next sum, that is question number 5. From the following transaction of Sri Gada Electronic Stores, prepare columnar purchase book. Sri Gada Electronic deals with TV, refrigerator and washing machine. Now in theory portion we have learned that there are two type of columnar cash book. One is related to types of goods. So see here, types of goods, TV, refrigerator and washing machine is given. And one is which is related to expenses. So see, in the next sum we can see that which expenses are there. Railway freight is there, labor is there. Fine. See, expenses is there mentioned. So here, this is, in this sum we will prepare columnar, but it will be for expenses. Well, in this sum it is related to type of goods. So there is TV, refrigerator and washing machine. See how the format will come. So purchase book of Sri Gada Electronic Stores, date, name of supplier, inward invoice number LF amount. Your TV column is separate, refrigerator, washing machine, and then total amount. That is the total of all this TV, refrigerator, and washing machine. All three we will write down here. Now see the first transaction, what they have given, 2015 May. So here first of all, 2015 May. We will see which date transaction is coming. Purchase 10 TV set, 30,000 of rupees each set. 5 refrigerator of rupees 15,000 per piece and 2 washing machine 18,000 per piece from Daya Electronics Store. Credit period 1 month, invoice number is 100. See, itself they have mentioned that there is a credit period. It means this is a credit transaction, so it will be recorded. Fine. So here, now see, here you are preparing, though TV, refrigerator and washing machine is asset, but here this is a separate columnar cash book for the, that is TV, refrigerator and washing machine. So this, when columnar is there, so you have to do for this. Okay, when goods are there, then in that case, as in the previous sum, goods is there, but that you are not supposed to record. Here you will only record this three only. Other than that, you will not record. Fine. So see, first, purchase 10 TV set, and from where you are purchasing, so Sri Daya Electronics Store. So let us write down first that, that is the date is 1 Sri Daya Electronic Stores account. Fine. Then 30,000 rupees each set. So how many total sets are there? 10 are there. So 10 into 30,000, it will be, that is 3 lakh. Fine. 10 TVs are there and 30,000 is the amount of one TV. So 30,000 into 10, there will be 3 lakh. Then 5 refrigerator of rupees 15,000 per piece. So again, what you'll do, that is 15,000 multiply by 5. So what you'll get? You'll get, that is 75,000 for refrigerator. Then washing machine. So 18,000. 2 washing machines are there and per piece is the cost is 18,000. So 18,000 into 2. So what you'll get? You'll get, that is 36,000 when you'll multiply 18,000 into 2. And lastly, what they have given, inward invoice number is 100. So here write down, that is inward invoice number is 100. Now we will do the total of all these three. So see, 3,75,000 and 36,000. So 3 lakh plus 75,000 plus 36,000. So what you are getting? 4,11,000. That is the total amount you are purchasing from Sri Daya Electronic Store. Then see the next transaction. 7. Purchase from Sri Tarak Electronic Store 5 pieces TV at rupees 25,000 per piece and 10 refrigerator at rupees 16,000 per piece at 10% trade discount. See, in this sum there is 10% trade discount, so you have to deduct it. Received invoice number 151. Half of the amount paid immediately. See, half amount is paid immediately. It means this half amount which you have paid immediately, you will ignore and you will consider it as a credit transaction. That we have learned, that we will consider it as a credit transaction. Fine. So here we will write down, that is day 7. That is date is 7th and party's name is Sri Tarak Electronic Stores account. Fine, like this, Sri Tarak Electronic Stores account. Inward invoice number they have mentioned 151, so here we will write down 151. Now what they have mentioned, 5 pieces of TV at rupees 25,000. So 5 into 25,000, that is 125. So 1,25,000 you will write down, like this. Clear? Then refrigerator, 10 we have to calculate here, trade discount is also there. Fine. 10% is trade discount. So see, now minus 10%, what you are getting? 1,12,500. So do the correction here, 1,02,500. Okay, so 1,12,500. Again, if it is not visible, I am writing here 1,12,500 amount. Clear? Then for the next one, it was how much? So 10 refrigerator and into 16,000 per piece. So here you, what you'll do, 10 into 16,000 and then minus, that is 10% trade discount. So what you are getting, that is, what is this refrigerator, is this? Okay, so here in refrigerator column you will write down 1,44,000 after deducting the trade discount. So this plus TV, so plus 112,500. So what you are getting? 256,000 2,56,500 is the total amount. So write down here 2,56,500. Then see the next transaction. Purchase cycle. See, cycle is not in your list. Okay, so this will be treated as an asset. This is not your goods because you are not dealing in cycle. So no need to put any entry for this. So cancel this. Purchase 5 refrigerator, 20,000 per piece, 10 washing machine at 15,000 per piece at 10% trade discount and 5% cash discount from Sri Atmaram electronic store and amount paid immediately. See, you are paying full amount immediately. As you are paying full amount immediately, so this will be treated as cash transaction. So no entry for this also. Placed an order to Srimati Babita for supplying 20 pieces TV at 28,000 per piece and 6 washing machine per piece. See, here you are just placing an order. When you are placing an order, it is non-economic transaction. So again, there will be no entry for this. Then, from Sri Gokuldam Electronic Store, purchased 5 pieces TV sets at 30,000 per piece, 5 washing machine 23,000 per piece. Trade discount is there 10% and invoice number is 123. So see, here nothing is mentioned and here party's name is mentioned. So here you will write down the name of the party. Okay, so here it is a credit transaction. So the date is 31st and you will write down Sri Gokuldam Electronic Stores account. The invoice number they have mentioned, it is 123. So here you will write down 123. Fine. Then what they have mentioned, purchased 5 pieces TV set at rupees 30,000 per piece. And see, remember there is 10% trade discount. Okay, so don't forget as we did previously. So 5 multiply by 30,000, then minus 10%. So what you are getting, 1,35,000 we are getting after deducting the amount of trade discount. Then what is their washing machine? Again, 5 washing machine at 23,000 per piece. So see, refrigerator is not there. So put dash in the column of refrigerator. And then for washing machine, 5 multiply by 23,000. And then minus 10% trade discount. So what you are getting, 103,500. Now addition of this two. So plus 1,35,000. That is 2,38,000. 500. Clear? Like this. Now all the transactions are over. Fine. So what you'll do, you'll find out total credit purchases. Fine. See, the total of all this you have to find out. Fine. So first we will do for TV. What is the amount for TV given to you? See, TV amount is 3 lakh. So here 3 lakh plus 1,12,500. Fine. So plus 1,12,500 plus 1,35,000. So 1,35,000. What are you are getting? So 5,47,500. Fine. Then in the next one, refrigerator, 75,000 and 1,44,000. So 75,000 plus 1,44,000. What you are getting? That is 2,19,000. Here we will write down. Then we will do for washing machine. So 36,000 plus 1,035,000. That is 1,03,500. So it is coming 1,39,500. And now see, press GT button directly. So you will get the grand total. See, now here it is not coming, so here we will do this. Okay, 4,11,000, 2,56,500 and 2,38,000. Here it was not coming because on button was pressed. So see, 4,11,000 plus 2,56,500 plus 2,38,500. So 9,06,500. Fine. See, I'll show you again this calculation, how GT button is being used up. See, when you'll do the total of this, fine, 3 lakh plus 112,500 plus 135. Clear? This is coming. Here we will write down 5,47,500. Now do not press on button, directly do. So 75,000 plus 1,44,000 okay, what you are getting, 2,19,000. Again, do not press on button. Previously I pressed on button, so I did not got, okay. So here this is coming again. Now the third column, that is 36,000 plus 103,500. See what you are getting, 1,39,500. Now when you press, you are pressing GT button, see directly it will come, that is 9,065. By mistake I wrote it, okay, 9,060, that is 9,06,000. So when you do like this, okay, without pressing on button, so you'll get this total. See, again we will check this, we 4,11,000 plus 256,500 plus 2,38,500. So see what you're getting, 9,06,000. Is this clear? So here the sum gets over, which is a columnar purchase book for the types of goods. Clear? So this is your question number 5. Now see question number 6. Abhishek Stores of Rajkot is iron merchant. Prepare purchase book in his books of account with columns of expenses. See, now this is a columnar cash book which is related to expenses. He maintains separate column for expenses like GST, railway freight, labor. Prepare purchase book applying total 12% GST rate. Okay, so the rate of GST is 12%. GST is not included for following transaction. Add applicable amount on of GST and prepare the purchase book. Okay, so this is the sum. Now see the format. Question number 6, columnar purchase book of Abhishek Store, date, name of supplier, inward invoice number, LF. See, first of all, net amount of goods. See, what do you mean by net amount of goods? So that is net amount of goods is equals to total amount minus trade discount. Okay, so when you deduct trade discount from your total amount, you get, that is net amount of goods. Then see, railway freight they have given. Okay, so here they have mentioned railway freight is there and labor is there. So railway freight is there, wages means nothing, but that is labor and wages are one in the same. After that, see what is their intrastate supply. See, what do you mean by intrastate? Again, we will revise, that is within the state, that is within Gujarat. Okay, and interstate means outside Gujarat. Okay, so in intrastate, that is within Gujarat, there will be input CGST and there will be input SGST, that is central and state. And here IGST, where there is interstate supply. Okay, so here you have to remember that what is the GST rates. So GST rates are applicable, that is 12%, and there is total amount. So total amount from year till year IGST. So the total amount of all this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the amount of the 6 total amounts you will add and you will write down here in the column of total amount. Okay, so this is the format. You have to prepare the format like this for this particular sum. Now we will see the first transaction. See, 2018 April. So here first we will write down, that is 2018 April. Clear? Now what is there given to you? See, first transaction, goods purchased of rupees 50,000, 10% trade discount from Shahrukh Stores, labor of 2,000 and railway freight of rupees 5,000 are disclosed, invoice number is 51. See, from Shahrukh Store, so they have not mentioned the cash word and party's name is mentioned, it means it is a credit transaction, so we have to record the entry for this. So first you will write down the date, that is April 1st, Shahrukh Store account. Fine, inward invoice number is 51. So here 51, see net amount of goods. So net amount of goods, what I have told you, total amount minus trade discount. So see here, what is the amount? 50,000 and minus 10% trade discount. So what you will get, 50,000 minus 10%. So see, 50,000 minus 10%, what you are getting? 45,000. So here in this column we will write down 45,000. Clear? Further, what they have given, labor is how much? 2,000. So here in the column of labor we will write down 2,000. Then in the column of railway freight, it is 5,000. So here we will write down 5,000. And see here, it is not mentioned. The place is not mentioned. So we will assume that the place is within Gujarat itself. That is Rajkot. Okay. As they have not mentioned the place. So here GST will be applicable. That is 12%. So here both are divided into input CGST and input SGST. So here 12%, how you will do? See. So total amount is 45,000 plus 5,000 plus 2,000. So 45,000 plus 5,000 plus 2,000. On this amount you will first calculate 12%. So into 12%, you are getting this amount 6,240. Now this is to be divided between both of this input CGST and input SGST. So you are divided by 2. So what you get, that is 3,120. So here you will write down 3,120. Here also you will write down 3,120. Here see, the transaction is not taking place outside Gujarat. So here input IGST will not come. So here put the dash. So now do the total from year till year. Whatever is coming, we will write down in this column. So what we are getting, see, 45,000 plus 5,000 plus 2,000 plus 3,120 plus 3,120. So the amount we are getting, that is 58,240. So here we will write down 58,240. Fine. So this first transaction is over. Then see the next transaction we will see, that is goods purchased of rupees 30,000 at 5% trade discount from Deepika. Total amount paid immediately. See, the total amount is paid immediately, so no need to read further here, as this is your cash transaction. We will not record this transaction. Next transaction, goods purchased of rupees 40,000 at 10% trade discount from Amitabh of Mumbai, Maharashtra. Bill number 251 received inclusive of labor 1,000 and railway freight 2,500. See, now this transaction, it's taking place in Maharashtra, that is outside Gujarat. So here what will be applicable, that is interstate supply, that is input IGST will be calculated, and this too you won't calculate because it is not within Gujarat. Fine. So first of all, here Amitabh of Mumbai, see, party's name is mentioned, it means this is not your cash transaction also. So we will record this transaction. Here we will write down, that is 20 and Amitabh. So Amitabh account invoice number, that is bill number, is mentioned 251. So here we will write down 251. Goods 40,000 at 10% trade discount. So net amount of goods we will write down, that is 40,000 minus what they have given, 10% trade discount. So 10%. So what you are getting, that is 36,000. So here we will write down 36,000 in the column of net amount of goods. Then what is there further? Labor. Labor is 1,000. So here labor column is there. So here we will write down 1,000. Then railway freight is there. So railway freight is 2,500. So here in the column of railway freight, we will put 2,500. Now see, as it is not within Gujarat, so here you will put dash, okay, and you will calculate IGST, that is directly 12%. So 36,000 plus 2,500 and 1,000. So plus 2,500 plus 1,000, you are getting this amount 39,500 multiply by 12%. What you are getting? 4,740. Clear? Now addition of all this. So see, 36,000 plus 2,500 plus 1,000 plus 4,740, this last amount. So 4,740. What amount you are getting? 44,240. So here we will write down 44,240. Clear? So this transaction is over. Then see further, a machine. See, it is a machine. So here also we will, goods word is not there. Fine. So it is an asset. So here we will cancel it. We won't do any entry for this. Goods purchased of 25,000 at 10% trade discount and 5% cash discount from Anushka of Chennai. Again, it is Tamil Nadu. It is outside the Gujarat. And party's name is mentioned. Cash word is not given. As cash word is not given, no need to calculate cash discount. We will calculate only trade discount. Okay? Because it is not to be taken into consideration, because it is a credit transaction. Party's name is mentioned. inclusive of railway freight of rupees 500. Clear? So railway freight is how much? 500. So here we will write down Anushka's name. So date is 30. Anushka account. Inward invoice number is what? So 44. So here we will write down 44. Net amount of goods first. So 25,000 minus 10% trade discount. So see, 25,000 minus 10% trade discount. What you are getting? 22,500. So here we will write down 22,500. Clear? Then see, only one expense is there, that is railway freight 500. So railway freight is of rupees 500. Wages is not there. So again here, see again it is Tamil Nadu, outside Gujarat. So this two will not come, only IGST will come. Clear? Now what will be there? So addition of all this, both of the things, so plus 500, what you are getting? 23,000. And now IGST into 12%, so that is coming to 2760. Now we'll add all these three, so plus 23,000 it was, so 25760. So here it will be 25760. So here all the transactions are over, sum is over. So now what you'll do, you'll do the total of all these items. Fine. So here, see, that is, we will write down total credit purchases. Fine. Now what you'll do, see, the total of all this. Fine. So here, first we will do 45,000 is there, plus 36,000, plus 22,500. So what do you get? That is 1,35,000. So 1,35,000 we will write down here. Then what is there? So 5,000 plus 2,500 plus 500. So we get, that is 8,000. Then 2,000 plus 1,000, it is 3,000. Here 3,120, 3,120. And here 4,740 plus 2,760. So what is the addition? 7,500. Here we will write down 7,500. Now we will do the addition of all this. So see, 7,500 is there on the screen. Fine. So plus 3,120. Plus 3,120 again, plus 3,000, plus 8,000, plus 1,035,000. What we are getting? 128,240. So 1,28,240. Again, we will cross check from this. Your standing total will do. So 58,240. Plus 44,240 plus 25,760. So here 128,240. So this total is tallied. Okay, so from this also tallied, from here also it tallied, so that there are no scope of a mistake. So here this is the sum which is based on, that is columnar purchase book based on, that is expenses. Fine. So first sum we did, it was purchase book, simple purchase book. Second, it was columnar, but it was for the types of goods. And third purchase book, it is columnar purchase book. I hope all the three sums are clear to you. Note down the sums in your fare book. And if you have any query, then please ask.